Hello everyone, let us move on to the chemical properties of the chapter aldehydes as well as ketones. In this part we have a major part of the reaction is a condensation reaction. What happens when aldehydes and ketones undergoes condensation with ammonical derivatives? I have to use the word is NH2G. G is any substitutions, is the ammonical derivative. These are the ammonical derivatives. With general formula NH2G. What happens when aldehydes and ketones undergoes condensation? Well, let us begin with general reaction, friends. And this is your aldehyde RC, double bond O, and this is H. Aldehyde is undergoes reaction with your ammonical derivative as our convenience I mentioned like this, NH2G. Yes. When aldehydes is condensed with ammonical derivatives, the condensation will be takes place, friends, the release of anion water. To release anion water. Yes, what about the condense? This RC, the carbon is condensed with the nitrogen like this. RC, this is H. The C double bond N, this is your H. Yes, the condensed product we call is skip base. We mentioned the name. When aldehydes or either ketones is react with any ammonical derivatives, so ammonical derivatives with the loss of water to form a product is called skip base. It is a general reaction of aldehydes. As similar to the ketones, friends, here's this R, see this is your R and double bond O, ketone. Is react with your ammonical derivatives. Here also the loss of water, this is your loss of water, the loss of water. Now the product is RC, this is your R, the carbon nitrogen double bond will be displaced, the C double bond N, this is G, this is also called skip base. This is a condensed product. I repeat once again, the condensation reaction takes place in aldehyde ketone. Is react with ammonical derivatives like NH2G or NH2X. You can mention any substitution. Yes, the formation of the product with loss of water is skip base. Repeat, aldehyde ketone react with ammonical derivatives with loss of water to form the product involving carbon nitrogen double bonds are called skip base. This is the general mention of condensation reaction in our syllabus. Yes, as mentioned in our syllabus, friends, we have various types of ammonical derivatives in PUC second year syllabus. We have list out first and then we start practicing those ammonical derivatives. What are those? Very simple. The first one in our syllabus is an NH2. G means OH. Name of this compound, hydroxyl amine. This is the first one. Second one is NH2. Name of this compound, hydrazine. Number third, C6H4NH2. Name of this compound, phenyl hydrazine. NH2, NH, C double bond O, NH2, name of this compound, semi-carboxyl. The next one, this is NH, NH2, already we know, this is phenyl hydrazine, this is phenyl hydrazine. Yes, we have a 2 nitro group, a second position and a fourth. Shortcut, the name of this compound is very important, 2,4-DNP, complete name 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are 5 ammonical derivatives are mentioned in our syllabus, the condensation reaction. Let us begin, friends, with the aldehydes and ketones with corresponding example. Yes, first one, what happens when aldehyde RC double bond O and H? This is your aldehyde. What happens when aldehyde is react with NH to OH? As convenience, I write like H to N, this is your H. Name of this compound? Hydroxyl amine. Hydroxyl amine to removal of O. Similarly, in the your general reaction. And removal of water, what it remains? RC. H double bond N. This is R C H. This is a double bond N. This is what? The name is very important, friends. We use hydroxyl amine, and the final product you can use aldehyde oxime. Aldehyde oxime. In shortcut, we use aldoxime. A L D O X I M E. What happens when aldehyde react with hydroxyl amine to form the product is aldehyde oxime or aldoxime. Yes, we can use an example for this. Yes, this is a CH3, C double bond O, CH. We know this is acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde. What about the IPAC with 2 carbon? 2 means ethanol. Very good. Ethanol is react with H2NOH. You know already hydroxyl amine with the loss of water. This is the loss of this is the loss of water. Yes, now what forms is CH3CH double bond N. This is H. Based on this, we can use a name. Acetaldehyde oxime, very simplest name. I repeat, when acetaldehyde reacts with hydroxyl amine to form acetaldehyde oxime. This is in the case of aldehyde. What happens in your ketone? What happens in ketone? I mentioned in ketone, friends, R C double bond O, this is your R. You keep in your mind, it is your ketone. And ketone is reacted with H2NOH. The name of this compound? Hydroxyl amine. Yes, with the loss of water. This is the loss of water. The name of this compound is R. C, R as it is, C double bond N, this is OH. What about the name of this compound? Ketone oxime. Ketone oxime, or either another name, ketoxime. This is your name of the compound. I repeat, ketone undergoes react with hydroxyl amine to form ketone oxime. Yes, I mentioned example here only, friends. So this is your corresponding example is CH3, C double bond O, CH3. I think all of you know, name of this compound is acetone. Acetone undergoes reduction reaction with your hydroxyl amine. Yes, to form this water. This is your water. The mention loss of water. What it remains, Ca3 as it is, and this is CH3, and double bond N, this is your H. What about the name of the compound? This is derived from acetone. This is acetone oxime. Similarly, we can use different ketones. I repeat, ketone undergoes react with hydroxyl amine to form ketoxime or ketone oxime, like acetone to form acetone oxide. This is the first condensation reaction by using, as our syllabus is, hydroxyl amine. I repeat, aldehyde or ketone react with hydroxyl amines to form either aldoxime or either ketoxime. Yes, similarly, friends, by using the same concept of hydroxylamine. Let us move on to the second example. Is mentioned already in our syllabus. It is a hydrazine. It's a very, very important part. What happens when hydrazine reacts with your aldehyde? Yes, I have to use a general reaction as well as corresponding examples. Sir, start with your RC double bond O H. You already know aldehyde. Is react with hydrazine as convenience H2N NH2. Hydrazine, spelling in category HYDRAZINE, hydrazine with loss of water. Yes, this is a loss of water. What it remains RC, this is your H as it turns on double bond N NH2. What is the name of this compound? This is aldehyde derivative, this is aldehyde. Hydrazines, after condensation, they converted into hydrazones. ZONE, after condensation, the skip base name is called zone, O-N-E. Zine converted into zone. I repeat, aldehyde react with hydrazine to form aldehyde hydrazone. Yes, friends, to keep yourself in your practice with example, CH3, C double bond O, this is H. Yes, what is the name of this compound? Is acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde reacts with hydrazine. This is NH3NH2 hydrazine. Yes, this is a loss of water. Very simple, you have to practice carefully. Loss of water. Yes, now the CH3. See, this is H double bond N, this is NH2. Can you give me the name of this compound based on this? This is acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde. Yes, the compound hydrazine is hydrazone. This is acetaldehyde. Hydrazone is. Yes, acetaldehyde and was react with hydrazine to form acetaldehyde. Hydrazone. This is in the case of aldehydes. Yes, can you agree with me? It's a ketone. It's RC double bond O. This is your ketone. Reaction same H2NNH2. Hydrazine. Similar reaction. Yes, loss of water. This is a loss of water. Now what it remains RCR double bond N NH2. Yes, can you give the name based on here? Yes, this is ketone. What happens? Hydrazone. Very simple. Can ketone react with hydrazine to form ketone hydrazone? With example, yes, can you practice? This is your CH3CH3 double bond name acetone. Reacts with H2NNH2. H2NNH2 with the loss of water. Same process. Now, CH3, CCH3, double bond NNH2. Condensation is finished. Acetone, hydrazone. Name acetone, hydrazone. This is the second reaction. Friends, I repeat once again, either aldehyde or either ketone react with hydrazines to form corresponding hydrazone. Just to keep in your mind, just replace water. Just replace water, condensation of carbon to the nitrogen with double bond. Hydrazines to the hydrazones. Today we have two condensations. One is hydroxylamine, second one is hydrazine. Yes, keep practicing with a different example with condensation. You very well example, acetaldehyde, formaldehyde, propanaldehyde theory. So acetone means 2-propanone. You can use butanone, pentanone. You can use condensation reaction for any aldehydes, either aliphatic or aromatic. And in the next video, we continue the next concepts. Thank you.